All right, Dad Bod episode 2. Seeing my squat session first, I'm working up to a single with 415 here. And like I said in the last video, squats are feeling pretty good. This is as heavy as I've pushed it for a long time. And for any of you wondering, I do have safety arms on the way. But again, this is the first time I've worked up to a weight this difficult in a long time. So that was probably an RPE 8 or so. So now that I'm getting a little bit closer to where I could potentially fail, I do have those spotter arms for bench press as well. And you'll see that too coming up. So a top single with 415 and then two sets of four with 365. Doing pretty good. Yeah, so the sets of four ended up being harder than the single. But I'm happy with my depth here. Definitely well past parallel on these, which is technically not the best for powerlifting. If I stopped a little higher, I could probably do a little bit more weight. But this is really just for me, and my PRs in the past have been at about this depth, so I can still track. All right, so this will be the last set. Just two sets of four with 365 on this day. Cheap knee sleeves from Amazon. Seem to work fine. I'm not worried about them being insanely tight or anything, as long as they don't move around and, you know, seem to make a difference. That's fine. Yeah, so that was it for that day. And that was actually the whole training session because I had to go to work. And then this was when I got home that night. A lot of the time I will just put this on a different day, but on this particular day I actually did two sessions. Here's my totally mediocre calves. I've never really considered myself team no calves, but compared to my quads, I guess I could. I've always just considered them average. They're not good or bad. So this is just body weight. What I'm considering doing moving forward, and this will be a little bit down the road, I'm not too worried about it, but I'm considering getting a belt squat and then just setting it up pretty high so that I can do calf raises with some resistance, because I'm not going to buy a leg press or anything like that. There's not any room. That's just not a priority. So we'll see. You may see some weird calf variations in the future. Got hamstring curls here. And for this particular hamstring curl, I don't have to use much weight at all. So on this day, I did four sets of, I think it was supposed to be eight, but it ended up being a set of six on the last one. Maybe seven, but you'll only see one set. Decided not to film all the sets of the accessories. But yeah, I've had this bench for like 15 years, and just recently went and picked up the attachment for leg extensions and hamstring curls. So some hanging leg raises. For abs, all I do are leg raises and ab wheel rollouts. Very simple, but fairly difficult exercises, just like everything else. You know, something that's difficult for a set of 8 to 12, and on this day, I think it was 3 sets of 12. If you notice any like ticking in the background, I'm not sure what's up with my recording setup. There's some kind of interference and I have no idea where it's coming from, but yeah, maybe you don't hear it. So this is just kind of a fun exercise for me. Makes me feel a little bit like an athlete. You see that I have these tires usually up on the wall. Do single leg jumps, and the harder part of this is actually getting the foot back down to land on it. And typically I do four on each leg, and you'll see when I move to the left leg, I remember this, that I kind of slipped on the push off and just barely landed it, but it happens. And this is also just a little bit of extra hamstring and calf work. Okay, that one was better than the first. That was it. Go to bench press. It's the following morning. So those sessions weren't very far apart, but that second session of hamstring curls, calves, and jumps and abs was not super taxing. So I felt fine to do this the next morning. My top single with 260, and I'll reiterate that the safety arms are on the way, but I knew that I wasn't that close to failure on this day. Single 260, felt pretty good. Bench is still not anywhere near where I would like it to be, but it never really has. Yeah, and so since I didn't want to have to move the bench to do a superset of bench and pull-ups, I used my pull-up bar, and I just filmed one set of these, but I was supersetting these with bench press. But this is such an awkward angle to film that I only got one set. And it was just four sets of eight on this day. Just make sure to control the negative and then a slight pause at the bottom. So it was a top single with 260, and then it was three sets of four with 230. You'll see all three sets, wearing the neck pillow, still seems to help. There it is. Three sets of four. That's what I said, isn't it? Moving pretty well for me. And so this was the last exercise of that day. It was three sets of 12 on these decline push-ups, and I had the handles set on a couple of 35-pound plates to get a little bit more range of motion. This was my accessories day, so you just see one set of each. You can bring your elbows up higher on this. I like this position, going up higher, tends to aggravate my shoulders a little bit. But again, just a slow eccentric and a slight pause at the full stretched position. This is one of my favorite triceps exercises, especially since there's essentially no setup. I just walk in here, do this one. So I kept it simple. I did that exercise for five sets, and I also did this exercise for five sets, just supersetting the two triceps and biceps. And for triceps, I was doing sets of 10. Biceps, it was just sets of 8, I believe. But 5 sets, just one exercise. And then last exercise, three sets of 10 here. Obviously. And that's it for this one. Please like the video if you liked it, and don't if you didn't. I appreciate it.